Hi, I'm Eileen from Silver Hills Guest House, and I'd like to tell you about one of my favorite recipes, the basic cream sauce, which is in our Silver Hills Spa Cuisine book. Years ago, when my daughter was born, she was lacto intolerant, and I had to figure out a way to make cream sauces and not using dairy, and the basic cream sauce is what saved my life. And it's on page 104 in the cookbook. It is so easy, but the one thing you need to know is that you have to have a good blender. Have you ever had sand kicked in your picnic lunch? Well, that's what it will taste like if you don't have a good blender. Okay, so what we're going to start off with is a cup of raw cashews. You can also use blanched almonds, but they are drier nut and they take longer to blend. What you do is you get your raw cashews. They're not the pretty little ones in the can that you have at Christmas. They're the raw cashews. And what you do is you put these cashews into your blender and put water in and blend till creamy and smooth. They're going to write that on my gravestone because I always say it, but it's so important to have it creamy and smooth. As I said, a good blender is what counts, and my very favorite is a Blendtec. It really works well, and you can get them at quite a few different outlets and that. But what you want to do is you put your nuts in there, and it calls for 3 cups of water. I usually just put a little bit of it, like 1 cup of it in, and like so, and I blend till creamy and smooth. Just to, for time's sake and noise factor, I blended it already, and this is what it kind of looks like. It's creamy and smooth, just like milk or a dairy product. Then I add all my seasonings. It calls for a little bit of chicken style seasoning that we really, really like. It's a vegetarian vegetarian chicken seasoning, and then you add a little sea salt and whatever other seasoning you prefer. It's really, really neat because this basic cream sauce, you can just have it plain or you can add whatever seasoning to make it different. For example, we really like the roasted garlic and pepper one. We like the garlic plus. And my very, very favorite one is the vegetable and herb medley from my brother-in-law, John, who's a chef. And he happens to be here today. There you go, John. Do you want to just...
Well, thank you, Eileen. It's always an opportunity to be here at Silver Hills Guest House. And it's even a greater opportunity to use my variety of seasonings here at Silver Hills. One of my favorite, too, my personal favorites of my three seasonings is the herb and vegetable medley. And the reason being is it is a really great blend of some real fine herbs and vegetables. And as Eileen already mentioned, this basic cream sauce is just awesome. It's a fundamental sauce in the real world of cooking. And this herb and vegetable medley really, really accepts the flavor well when it's blended with the white sauce. So I hope when you visit Silver Hills that you have an opportunity to stop by and pick up a bottle. Thanks, honey.
Thank you. Anyways, we use it. I'm practically asleep with it because I like it so much. We sprinkle it on our potatoes and we sprinkle it on our vegetables and of course in my cream sauces. Now, with the cream sauce, once you've blended it creamy and smooth, don't forget that, and add the seasonings and a little bit of flour. If you want to make it, for pasta and that, you can add a little bit of the soya cheese to it. Once that's blended creamy and smooth, I just put a little bit of some of the water in my blender. I add the rest of the water into my saucepan, bring it to the boil, and then I carefully, once it's come to a boil, I stir this until it's come to a boil, and there's my cream sauce. From there, I can do anything my little heart desires. For example, that cream sauce can go on my favorite vegetables. What a nice treat, especially in the summer when you have creamed asparagus or creamed broccoli, creamed peas. Oh, yummy, yummy, yummy. Another thing, by adding different seasonings, like your chicken seasoning, maybe a little soya sauce, you can make a gravy out of that cream sauce, and it will make a delicious gravy on potatoes. You can add, instead of that, you can add cheese, a little bit of cayenne to give it a bite, and make scalloped potatoes out of it. Oh, there's such a variety of things you can do. You can also add the cheese to your cream sauce and a little bit of cayenne, a little bit of John's herbs, whatever else you want, and then basil. And that will give you the basil at the end. You don't want to blend that. And that will give you a creamy Alfredo. So you can see, once you know the basic cream sauce, it will give you such a variety of things that your world will come alive if you want to try not eating and using dairy. So that's it for today, and I just really encourage you to try this. It is, to me, it was a lifesaver, from a very bland menu to something that came alive, that I could make anything my little heart desires. So don't forget the basic cream sauce in the Silver Hills Cookbook, and you'll really, really enjoy it. Thanks.